Konnichiwa YouTubers, is Restock straight from Point Magoo, California. Today we're going to do a video review of Transformers Robots in Disguise Armor Hide. Now, this is actually a recolor of G1 Combaticon Brawl. And yeah, let's take a look at it. There's the packaging over here, Transformers Robots in Disguise. Here's the back, as you can see, forms Ruination. You also have a nice little storyline over here, so that's Armor Hide. So if you really want to read it, there you go. And made back in 2001, so very plain looking packaging, what can I say? So hey, let's remove that. Let's go ahead and take out the package. There we go. Comes with this really huge gun, which I really like. Of all the little four minicons, Legends figures, these are the one I like the best. Comes with this big gun and this little smaller gun. Kind of neat. I like this. I like this figure because you can pop this over here, and it does have a little slot over here to peg in the smaller gun. So yeah, you got one. As if he wasn't loaded for bear enough, this thing has enough weaponry. I mean, even with a turret, which does rotate 360. I really like that. Kind of hollow in the back, but not too bad. I wish that the turret would move up and down, but it just wiggles a little bit. Like the camouflage, it's really nice looking camouflage. You can see the blue and the Decepticon logo here, blue, white. Yeah, kind of like my uniform. So hides the extras on the bottom really well. Very nondescript painting, but other than that, it changes really well. And you know, just like anything else, it rolls. So move that over here. Yeah, it rolls well enough. I do like this big turret though. Yeah, makes it look much more intimidating. Transformation is rather unique for one of these things. It actually, the turret does pop out, legs fold over, and one of the cool neat things is that this rotates 90 degrees and his arms move out, and you can pop this back out. So not too bad looking. The turret still rotates. I wish it had a little bit more. Only thing I really don't like is that this doesn't go anywhere, it doesn't attach anywhere, and I'm really disappointed about that. I guess if you want, you can store it there, but that looks silly. Gun, this is a small gun, it only sits right here. So there you go. Has movement over here in the shoulder, and that's about it. But his camouflage looks really good, so that's why I'm going to give him a 7 out of 10 on both modes, because he looks really good. Even the head sculpt is, even as generic as it is, he got the eyes right. Alright, so let's go ahead. Size comparison time here. There he is with Bumblebee, and as you can see, he's a little taller this time. So where is my G.I. Joe? There we go. G.I. Joe right here for another size comparison, looking good. And last but not least, Megatron in the background to show you how tiny the guy really is. Alright. That's all I got, YouTubers, and I'll catch y'all next time.